drinking my milkshake.
Ooh, so fancy.
You ever go to Sonic and get one of those milkshakes that's so thick you can't get it through the straw, and they give you this little tiny straw?
Listen, I've always wanted to go to a Sonic. I just never, whenever I've been to the States, never got the chance to.
They don't have Sonic in Canada?
They do not have Sonic in Canada.
What?
Yeah, no, we don't have that. So I have to go, like, somewhere in the States to get it there.
Huh. I did not know that. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, if you order a milkshake, make sure you get a fucking spoon, because they're going to give you this little bitty straw that's, like, that big, and then you're going to be... You'll be looking like a fucking alien when you're done.
Like a xenomorph out here.
Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, man, like one of the Greys with that little tiny mouth and big ass head. I sure didn't know that, though. That's really fucking interesting. Oh, man. I learn something new every day, I guess.
CIL.
Welcome to the show, folks.
Hit that intro.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Guns in Radio podcast. And now, give it up for your hosts, Chris Caputo and Dustin Bonez.
It's episode 130 of Guns in Radio.
Oh, wait, 130, there we go.
Yeah, get it. I don't know.
Yeah. Wait, yeah, because I got to do the one.
I'm not gangster.
Oh, there we go, right there. There we go. There's the gangster one. Oh, that's 103. There we go. One. Nobody listening to the podcast is going to understand what the fuck is going on. Wait, here we go. Yeah. There we go. Wait, I need the one to be over here. Goddamn, this is hard. Damn it. There we go. There we go. Man, I feel like I'm feeling like I'm a blood with arthritis. Like, oh my God. Welcome to the show, everybody. Woo. Man, we got a really fun show for you today. We're gonna be listening to Perfect Crime. We're gonna be watching a music video, and on top of all of that, we have got some stories for you of some of the stupidest criminals who maybe we should say committed the most imperfect of crimes.
Yeah, I think imperfect would be better. So I was going to go with unperfect, but I'm just like, that doesn't make sense.
Imperfect crimes.
Yes, crimes gone wrong, we'll just say.
Well... crimes that went wrong that in probably a lot of these cases, at least the ones I've picked out, probably shouldn't have gone nearly as wrong as they did.
Yeah, but, you know, some people are just idiots and things happen.
Yeah, man, it's just, it's like my daddy used to say, if you're stupid, you don't need to be a criminal, so.
Exactly.
Yeah. It was life advice my father gave me to live by.
That's a pretty damn good advice, I was going to give you that.
Well, first off, we got a little bit of news. This happened last week, right after we taped our show. DJ Ashba, everybody's favorite former Guns N' Roses member. he's very popular with this community.
Yes, DJ Slashba.
Released Bella Chow. Is it Bella Chow?
Bella Chow, yes.
Bella Chow. Well, he had released it. He released it before we... what's the word I'm looking for? We'd already... It was out when we did the show last week, but we wanted to wait for the music video to drop so that we could review the music video on the show.
Mm-hmm. I believe you just sent it to me right now, so...
Yeah. And I sent it to you.
Yeah, that's what we're... Okay.
We're going to get us some Bella Chow.
Yeah, we're going to get us some fucking Italiano in here.
Italiano.
Mambo Italiano. As someone of Italian descent, I'm cringing when I say that.
I forget that you're Italian, man. You can translate this shit for it. Okay, good.
Slightly. I I can terribly attempt to translate it. I'll help someone in the YouTube comments. Probably already did, so.
Well, that's no fun. But, okay.
Maybe if they did. No one has.
Oh, they haven't?
No. God damn it. Wasn't it his birthday recently, DJ Ashby?
It was. I think it was DJ Ashby's birthday. We're recording this on Veterans Day in the United States. Remembrance Day
for the Canadians.
Remembrance Day for the Canadians. So thank you to everybody who served in either one of our militaries. I learned on this show, either on this show or before this show through Mr. Caputo, that Canada does have a military.
Yes. We're not just pussies.
I'm not sure why, but...
we're still wondering, too. Don't worry.
We got one in America. We use it.
No, you just spend a bunch of money on it.
Yeah, that's fair. And then we treat them like shit when they come home.
Yeah, you just use people for a dick flexing competition.
I know, man. I'm telling you, this is how every war should be fought. And I don't mean any disrespect to any of the veterans out there, but I'm going to tell you right now, we'd have far less wars if every war should be fought where the leader of those two countries meet and duke it out themselves.
Exactly. I would put that shit on pay-per-view, man.
Fuck yeah. I'd be sitting there watching my president go up against somebody else's. I mean, shit, like Osama bin Laden come out and he's like, I challenge you to a fight. And then you got Bruce Buffer in the mix, like, and in this corner,
fighting
on behalf of the Taliban.
Fighting out of parts unknown in Afghanistan.
From a cave.
From a cave in the Middle East.
Osama bin Laden! And you hear, boo!
This fight brought to you by Bud Light. Enjoy responsibly.
See, man, even more opportunities for capitalism this way.
And buy, like, some random, like,
Snickers
movie.
It'll be like Snickers, man. Snickers sponsors every damn thing. That's how they'll introduce. Standing in the Bud Light corner. Yeah, Red Bull.
Monster Energy. Red Bull. It really gives you wings.
Oh, man. Could you see George like Bush random, coming?
Like, have like some random fat burns, like sponsored by a stack or two.
I don't know, man. Wouldn't nobody be fucking with Canada? Because y'all's boy, he does fight.
Yes, he's a boxer.
Yeah, didn't he throw down with one of his opponents?
Yeah, I did like some charity thing like years ago. This is before he was prime minister, though.
Like that? Yeah, man. I'm all for it, man. We just get our leaders. And you know what? What'll quit happening is we'll stop electing 700-year-old dinosaurs and... these fucking pampered ass rich brats. Mm-hmm. And I can just see Don King doing commentary, like, you know, the pre-fight. Well, you know something? It's going to be a good one down here.
Okay, Joe Rogan will be doing a podcast while he's commentating the fight.
Who would be the commentators?
Aliens.
Let's see, we'll get Joe Rogan and Jim Ross. And
we'll get Moro Ronaldo to throw in like some pop culture references.
Mamma mia!
And just go and say, can't say holy shit, he has to say holy bleep.
Holy bleep! Joey Styles. Oh my god! For some reason, I don't think that these fights are going to warrant much. They're going to be a lot more hype than it will be. It'll be all sizzle and no steak, because this fight is going to last like 3 minutes max.
Yeah, just like most celebrity boxing matches.
Yeah, they are not athletes. I mean,
there was once a celebrity boxing show. It only lasted 2 episodes, though.
Oh, man. That'd be great. In a perfect world, that's how we do things. Nobody has to die.
It's true.
We just beat the shit out of each other. Oh, we don't beat the shit out of nobody. People like you and me sit back and watch. But I'm going to tell you.
I'm there in the front row with my popcorn. I'm just like, yeah, that's cool.
I'm going to tell you, though, if President loses that fight, he ain't getting reelected.
Nope. Better luck next time.
Well, guys, we're going to watch Bella Chow. Mm-hmm. Am I saying it right?
Yes.
Okay, good. We're going to watch Bella Chow by Ashba, formerly known as DJ Ashba. And if you want to watch along with us, there's a link to the music video in the description of this podcast. So go ahead and get that loaded up. You might have to pause me and Chris. And if it's your first time here, you might have to pause the podcast, load up the music video, get past the ads, do what you got to do. Pause it at the zero mark. And when we tell you to hit play, you hit play. And I gotta admit, I'm a little excited for this. I like DJ.
Yeah. I like a couple other ones. They're decent. We'll see what he's got planned right now. So
yeah, let's see how we do. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, count us down, brother.
In 3, 2, 1, play. All right, we start out with some skulls. Pouring us some shot. Is that Miley Cyrus?
Was that the Undertaker? Biker Taker was there.
Well, there's DJ sitting by himself at the bar, which does not happen.
Classical guitar.
Listen, man, I've been to the bar with DJ Ashba, and that is not how it goes down. He is not in the corner by himself. That like does a look
theme party. I don't know.
Now, this is his house. This is what his house looks like.
It's like his like other backyard.
Yeah.
I got two backyards.
This is his guest house. Yeah, buy a drink for the hot chick.
Oh, I thought he pulled out a condom. I was like, what?
Look at her swiping the credit card. Now, DJ just going to let it happen. You see that?
Yeah, the dude looks like a mix of Quentin Tarantino, like some dude from a mob movie, and Larry's
Oh, man. He looks like, what's his name? The guy that played The Godfather.
Marlon Brando?
Yeah, Marlon Brando. There.
Yeah, he looked like a 10-year-old kind of.
This guy looks like my neighbor. We got like the cat burglar over here, and DJ's just watching it all go down.
Yeah, he's just like devil's advocate. He's like, listen, I'm just gonna snitch on your ass.
He's just letting everybody get robbed, and he don't give a fuck.
The DJ was there for a second.
What's she gonna steal next? Is that the guy from Smash Mouth?
Or who knows? Looks like the bassist from No Doubt. Blonde dude.
He looks like one of those judges from one of those cake shows.
Is it like a master chef?
Yeah. No, a cake. You know, like when they make the cakes? Okay. And there's always the one flamboyant judge with fake blonde hair. How much of a haul do you think? Oh, he's back!
Yeah.
Cocaine dealer alien.
You said, yeah, he was his drug dealer.
Yeah. gotta get that space coke. Look at her, man. She's just going. That's going. We're going to do cut to DJ watching and not. Yeah, he's seeing it going on. He's like, this ain't my business.
I know you're a kleptomaniac, honey.
He's just watching it like, not my business. All right, yep. My drink's empty. She's going to eat me. It'd be funny if she walked up and snatched the money off the table.
What if he put like Monopoly money there?
Oh, now he's gonna be like Batman and the Catwoman. He's gonna go up there and kick her ass. You watch.
Oh yeah, Jack is coming off.
Yeah, he's getting to kick her ass. And then DJ kicked her ass and returned all of the. Wait, what? Oh. No, that's not what was supposed to happen. What kind of hero are you, DJ?
He's an anti-hero, damn it.
Not how this was supposed to go. Oh, wait. Yeah, there you go. I was right all along. And then he takes the loot for himself. Does he take the loot for himself, or does he return it to its rightful owners?
Who knows? He's going to Robin Hood that shit and just be like, whoop, throw it out in the air.
I have a feeling this is based on a true story.
This is based on multiple true stories.
Oh, man. Was that the... Is that his wife that was in that video?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
She... Why does she look different in every fucking music video? Have you noticed that?
It's the hair. It's the hair.
Well, she must have one of those faces that morphs with a different haircut, I guess.
I can only tell because of the tattoos, like the sleeves she has. Mm. That's how I can usually tell.
Right on.
So I noticed that the sleeves are, like, her, like, distinguishing sort of feature. Otherwise, like... I don't know, one of these videos she has bangs, the other one is like short, and it's like thrown back. I'm like, Jesus.
Oh, let's see. Let's see how it's doing on YouTube. 5,000 likes with only 63 dislikes. It's been up for 6 days. It's got 240,000 views. And let's see if we can squeeze a couple of comments out there. I was just wondering the other week what you've been up to, going back and listening to a lot of 6 a.m. late. Why are you trying to have a conversation with him? Like, shit. Not in the comments section. Oh, there is some DJ Ashba news. He's going to be playing live for those of you in the Green Bay, Wisconsin area.
Oh, shit.
Let me find the webby site here.
The webby site.
On that crazy internet Al Gore invented.
I haven't heard that one in a while, man. That's a throwback.
Tour. Friday, November the 12th. So, yeah, well, that's tomorrow. Oh, right? Well, if you're listening on Patreon.
Yeah. And if you attended the show, let us know.
Yeah. Well, yeah, if you attended,
let us know. We can get you on here for a show review or something.
Yep. It's going to be at the Epic. Well, by the time you hear this, the rest of the public hears this. It will have been at the Epic Event Center in Green Bay, Wisconsin. I really want to go to that. You want to see how much tickets are? Let's see how much tickets are.
Let's see.
You'll come
it's like a continuation of the prices right from last week.
Yeah. You come down tomorrow. Like, go ahead when we finish up. You get on a plane and come over here and we'll go see DJ Ashba. $75 for a meet and greet and includes a GA floor ticket.
That's not bad.
Okay. I'd pay $75 for the meet and greet, but I don't think I would need. I have a feeling that, I don't know, $75 for the sure thing, and then I don't gotta go and, like, feel creepy figuring out what bar he's at. But if I went to the meet and greet, he'd tell me, though, and we'd go hang out.
Yeah, and be like, listen, bro, pass me a cigarette. We go.
He did once. Yeah. Told you that story?
Yeah, I think I mentioned it here before, if you did.
I've still got that cigarette in a shadow box in Mississippi. It was a Marlboro Light. DJ smoked Marlboro Lights at the time. Oh. He don't smoke anymore, though.
Oh, he did.
No. He was in the process of quitting when he bought me the Jaeger bomb in Vegas. Mm-hmm. And he was vaping, though, like he didn't just quit cold turkey. He started vaping and then he quit smoking anyway. I do what show? There was a show one time where he came out, and I'd had a cup from earlier where I'd gotten a beverage, and DJ came out with, he drank a lot of Jaeger, at least at this time. It seemed like it was always Jaeger. I always saw him drinking at the time. and he was on stage, and he took a sip out of a bottle of Jaeger, and I yelled out, DJ, and I held my cup up like this, and he reached down and poured it in the cup. That was funny. Listen, Cooper, he's always been cool, though. Every time I've met him, he's been really cool, so. I mean, I want to hear more of his solo work. I know that that's not going to be a popular opinion amongst most of the community at large, but it's, you know, it's my opinion. I enjoy DJ Ashba, so. Whatevs, man, whatevs. Well, you want to talk about some stupid criminals, or?
Yeah, talk about some dumb fucks. Dumb fucks, not the drunk fucks, dumb fucks.
Dumb motherfucker. Dumb motherfucker, would you liberate your mind? Oh, man. I got in a disturbed mood this week, actually.
Ooh.
Now, I am pulling all of mine off of the New York Post, because earlier I went through several. The New York Post keeps stupid criminals updated a lot more regularly than they should have to. But I went through and chose a few of my favorites. How many of these do we want to do? Let's do three each.
All right. I was going to say we do like three or four each.
All right. Let's do four. That'll give us eight.
Yeah. Because mine are pretty short. I've just like literally found from like a bunch of different sources.
Okay. So what's your first one?
Let me see here. Let's do...
And then we'll rank them. Yeah. We'll rank them. We'll do it like a tournament, or what do you call it? A gauntlet? Who's the stupidest criminal?
Yeah. All right, I got one here. So in 2015, Christopher Wallace, a 24-year-old from Maine, was on the run from police after allegedly stealing cooking equipment. Having successfully evaded police for weeks, he started getting cocky, posting to Snapchat that he was at home hiding from the police. On seeing this, a couple of his followers alerted police, who then went to search his house. Despite the tip-off, police had no luck finding him. They called the search off. And that's when Chris posted again, saying police were in his house and he was hiding in a cabinet. And then they were alerted again to find that, because obviously the people on his fucking Snapchat are like, oh, look, he's in the cupboards. And then they found him.
And wait, he was in the cupboard the whole time while he was on Snapchat?
Yeah, he was hiding in his house, whatever, somewhere. And then, like, the first time. And then they basically told police, oh, he's in his house, whatever. And, like, they're trying to find him. And he's, like, posted again on his Snapchat, basically saying, yeah, I'm in the cabinets.
Could you imagine? It makes me think of the Estranged music video when the police come in or whoever.
He's, like, on the top shelf.
Yeah. And then you see Axel.
Look for the shelves.
See Axel with his cell phone out texting, stupid cops, LOL.
He's like live streaming it.
Live streaming it, yeah. Oh, that's pretty stupid.
Yeah, it is pretty dumb.
But let's put him up against this man named Michael Harrell. And he's from Ohio. And I'm just going to read the article here. A knucklehead Ohio bank robber slipped a teller a holdup note with his name and address scrawled on it. Michael Harrell, 54, entered the U.S. bank branch in Cleveland on Monday, and he passed the not-so-discreet note. When the teller took the note and looked and saw, and she looked at it, and then she flipped it over, and on the other side, she saw he had that his name and address had been used earlier. Basically, he went to the DMV and used his fucking paperwork and shit from there to write the holdup letter on it.
What the fuck?
So yeah, at that point you just let him go, right? I mean, fuck it. Well, no. Why? Let him run. Let him run home, think he's got away, and then when he's like taking a shit, we come busting in, you know. But what do you think? Who's stupider? The guy with the note Or the guy that gave away his location on Snapchat.
I think the cocky Snapchatter is still fucking stupid.
Think the cocky Snapchatter?
Yeah. All right. And I think this next one I got will probably may or may not take the cake, actually.
All right.
Yeah. So in August 2007, a woman in Rochelle, Georgia, successfully committed the crime of purchasing and ingesting crack cocaine. But after she split her purchase and smoked one-third, she found she wasn't intoxicated. Fearing that she had been ripped off, the woman, a 53-year-old Juanita Marie Jones, called local police to enlist their help to, quote, get her money back. When deputies arrived at her home, she showed her purchase to them, and they promptly arrested her for possession of crack.
Look, I'm unsatisfied with the quality of this crack. I'm going to call the popos.
I want my money back from my drug dealer.
What did you think was going to happen?
Please. What? Obviously, it was pretty good then, because you ended up calling the cops.
Okay, so one guy... Okay, so we've got the guy that gives away his location to the popo, though they're looking for him on Snapchat, versus the lady that straight up calls the popo and says, look, I bought some crack from this motherfucker. And
bought some shitty crack.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's tough.
I'm still going with fucking crack lady.
Yeah, I think crack lady's the new champion.
That's the new champ right now.
Yeah, because she actually called and confessed her crime. And everything. And I don't know... What I want to know, what did she think was going to happen? What outcome did she believe that this was going to have? I just don't know. Well, here's one for you. A man in the Bronx was wanted by the NYPD, and he was arrested in Pennsylvania on Wednesday after he was found locked in the trunk of a car. Mm-hmm. His name is Leon, with an unpronounceable middle name, Parks. He's 25 years old, and he was discovered in a 2016 Dodge Charger by an employee at the auto auction in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. And this is what the employee said. I opened up the trunk to take a picture, and there was a guy in there.
What the shit?
He said he quickly went to get the man some water because he wasn't moving a whole lot. The auction yard where he was found at is 90 miles west of Philadelphia. It turned out he was wanted on drugs and weapons charges, according to public records, and he was reportedly uncooperative and identified by his fingerprints. And we still don't know how he got into the trunk of the car.
That's fucking insane. What?
Don't know. How did he get... Was he put in there and a drug deal gone bad and left for dead?
Could have.
Did he crawl in there himself to hide from the cops and then realize this thing doesn't fucking open from the inside?
I feel like it could be like either or, but that's pretty fucking crazy.
So yeah, there's that one. I don't know. Crack Lady, I think, still is the champion.
Crack Lady. This one maybe could possibly take the throne here. In 2011, 53-year-old Michael Anthony Fuller from North Carolina walked into a Walmart store, bought a vacuum cleaner and a microwave for $476. That's not wrong, but he attempted to pay for his purchase using a $1 million note from Monopoly.
What?
After demanding change of $999,524, the police were promptly called and he was arrested.
Oh, man. I wonder where he came up with this idea. And then, like, the rationing he had. Because then he was like, man, why has nobody thought of this before? $1 million fucking note. Oh, man, that's funny. I don't know. That's tough, man. That one's hard. Which one's stupider, her or the crack, him or the crack lady? Oh, man. Hang on. Becky! I got a question. Let's draft Becky in.
We're going to get outside sources here?
Yeah. Let's do a little tiebreaker. We can't have many more of these, though, because I don't think I can do this more than once without her killing me. Hey, yeah. Okay, so we got two criminals here. We need to know which one is the stupidest. This one lady bought some shitty crack and realized she wasn't getting high, so she called the cops to help her go get a refund. Okay. Or this guy that made a scene in Walmart because he tried to pay for a microwave with $1 million Monopoly bill and demanded to be given change.
Probably the woman asking the cops help for more crack.
All right.
Well, all right, crack lady.
Your feedback. Crack lady it is.
Crack lady still taking Monopoly idiot is a close second, though.
Monopoly idiot is a good close second. That's a good sign, man. That was a good one. Well, how do you know it was Monopoly money and not Canadian money? Huh?
Well, he's in the North Carolina. I don't think they know fucking Canada exists in North Carolina.
Ric Flair's from North Carolina. Thank you.
Yeah, that's the only good thing about North Carolina.
All right. So I'm going to tell you another story here. This is about Chris Butler. He's a 36-year-old British man. He had been eluding police for months after escaping from jail in November. However, he was caught when he ventured out of hiding to go buy a copy of the new Call of Duty game.
Oh.
Black Ops Cold War. The fugitive.
Oh, fucking recent.
Yeah. The fugitive served 14 years of a 17-year sentence. He was caught on January 13th in Birmingham after officers saw him and a friend suspiciously change directions after spotting the police car. When the officer asked Butler for his and his companion why they were in town during the pandemic, because they were in lockdown, mind you, mm-hmm. he replied, "I've come to get this new Call of Duty because I can't sit around in lockdown." Then he admitted he was carrying marijuana.
I'm really fucking stoned, eh?
And he's back behind bars with an extra 2 years added to his sentence for breaking out of jail and attacking the officers.
Idiot.
Yeah, so who's stupider? The guy that was the fugitive that went out of hiding to go get the new Call of Duty game? Or the crack lady that called the cops?
I think crack lady is still stupid. Crack lady is just dumb. It's like, listen, you do drugs to not get caught by the cops. And you walked right into that one.
Yeah, well, how many you got left? You got...
If you want, we can do like one more each. I can find one more. I still have a few here.
All right, go ahead. Let's do one more. Because I'm going to find the one I was saving for last real quick here.
Let's try this one. So in suburban Miami in October 2007, an unidentified man placed an order at a fast food drive-thru. Upon hearing that his order would cost him $7.40, he let the cashier on the other end know that he wouldn't be paying more than the $1.75 that he had on him. After it was explained to him that wouldn't do, he drove off, only to return on foot moments later, pulling a gun on the employees and trying to unsuccessfully retrieve his order. He instead settled on a fistful of ketchup packets, but apparently decided on the way back to his car they weren't worthwhile. And, I don't think it doesn't say he got caught in here. He just basically ran off. Like, fuck this.
Well, that was pretty fucking stupid. I mean, what does he think is going to happen? They're not going to call the cops? Like, you're not on camera?
Yeah.
Like, this is a motherfucker that ain't never had a fucking job.
Yep.
So, let's see. Is drive-through... How do we word this?
Drive-through jabroni?
Drive-through jabroni.
I'm still going crack lady, though.
Crack lady? Okay.
Yeah, I think she's the undisputed, not king, but the queen, I think, of this. Unless we have someone that could possibly trump it.
Okay. This one might do it. This happened in Colorado Springs, Colorado. County Sheriff Jason Mike Sell recently received a text from a 39-year-old man offering to buy his SUV. The man sent photos, however, he didn't want to pay with cash. Instead, he offered to trade him 4 pounds of marijuana.
For a car?
Yeah. What? Oh, and this is apparently they have legal and illegal marijuana, because this is illegal marijuana. And I don't know the Colorado rules on marijuana when it comes to selling it. So anyway, the guy tried, the man offered the sheriff and sent pictures of the product, by the way, via text. 4 pounds of marijuana for the SUV. And he was arrested and charged with possession with intent to sell.
Literally, you're drug dealing.
It says, Mike still says that he won't, he will not be relisting the SUV on Craigslist again.
Yeah, some crazy's gonna fucking try and sell you crack. Then they're gonna call the cops and say, this crack is weak. I'm an SUV, I don't want these drugs.
Craigslist. Did I ever tell you the story about Dwayne and the chickens? Have I told that on here? I can't remember what story's
up. I don't think so.
So, well, hang on. We'll get to that in a minute. Who's stupider, crack lady or a guy texting the sheriff to try to trade 4 pounds of weed for his SUV?
I'm still going to go crack lady. That still fucking baffles my mind.
I can see that, because there's nowhere where crack is legal. Like, with the legalization of marijuana in Colorado, the rules might be a little fuzzy, okay? But the crack lady don't have any excuse. So there's our queen, stupidest criminal. Most imperfect crime goes to the crack lady. She is undefeated.
Congrats. No, we'll have to find her and send her a bag of doo-doo in the mail or something.
We'll send her a free copy of this podcast.
Yeah, I'll send you a Guns and Radio hat.
Oh, hell no. We ain't going to spend no money, dude. Come on. No way. When I say a copy, I mean a link to it. I mean like a link to where she can find it on her own on the internet. I'm not going to physically spend any money on it. But no, see, the thing I was wanting to tell you about with Dwayne and the chickens, Rick posted, we used to post Dwayne's phone number on Craigslist for stupid shit all the time. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, I think the chickens was the last time Dwayne spoke to us for a while, until he came back recently. Mm-hmm. And we put that I have 2 free chickens, free to a good home, whoever wants them, on Craigslist. And we put Dwayne's phone number. And then for 2 days, his phone just blew up constantly. And he'd hear him in the back, I ain't got no damn chickens. Why is everybody calling me about chickens? So he leaves, right, and he calls Rick a couple of days later and goes, man, motherfucker, take me off of Craigslist, you stupid bastard. I know that you put me on Craigslist. And Rick was like, I don't know what you're talking about, man. I didn't put you on Craigslist. My motherfucker, I know you did. You put me on Craigslist, said I got 2 free chickens and all this other shit. So I'm over here just laughing my ass off. And he goes, you know what I'm going to do, motherfucker? I'm going to show you. I'm going to put you on Craigslist to see how you like it. And then he hung up the phone on Rick. Mm-hmm. Well, about 2 minutes later, he calls back and goes, how do you post on Craigslist?
Oh, I'll just spit on my water.
Oh, oh man, good times. Good times.
Oh my god.
Well, now we've heard a little bit about some some imperfect crimes. We've watched a music video. What do you say we dive in and check out the perfect crime? And I'm not talking about the Italian.
Let's do it, man. Let's get ready. No. Well, that was last week.
What was last week?
We're doing Money, the Revolver cover. That was on the Italian Job soundtrack or in the end credits of the movie.
Oh, I didn't. Oh, yeah. That did come up. Huh. Oh, well. Here we go. I gotta tell you, I've never understood a word of this fucking song.
Well, you're lucky I got the lyrics here.
Yeah, so, yeah, let's do some lyrics.
Let's do, we'll start with the first verse here. Kicking back in the shadow, got no need for the light. Who's sorry now, old-timer? Look at how you spent your life. Scrounging for change to put some money in your pocket. My house scratched his burn. Laughing at the suckers as he pissed it away. But I got the time, even I got the muscle. I got the need to lay it all on the line. I ain't afraid of your smokescreen hustle. And then the chorus, it's a perfect crime. God damn it, it's a perfect crime. Motherfucker, it's a perfect crime. I said it's perfect, and then, you know, right from there.
Yeah, now I got that part. Now, before we start the second verse, I want you to do the give me some lyrics to that, and let's see if I can follow it, knowing what he's supposed to be saying.
Oh, it's about the second verse?
Yeah.
All right, so keep the demons down and drag the skeletons out. I got a blind man following me in chains. I said he's fun to watch when the world has stopped, and I think he's got something to say. You want to fuck with me? Don't fuck with me, because I'm what you'll be, so don't fuck with me. If you had a better sense, you'd just step aside from the bad side of me. Don't fuck with the bad side of me. Stay away from the bad side of me. Don't fuck with the bad side.
All right. Really getting some repetitive shit going on, but that's okay. All right, yes. Now let's hear it and play and see if I can understand it better. All right. So I guess you shouldn't fuck with him, is what he's trying to say.
Pretty much. Or don't fuck with him on his bad side, you know.
All right,
you'll like get Axel's like, you know, Dr. Jekyll to his Mr. Hyde kind of thing.
Yeah, I mean, at least he's warning you not to fuck with him.
Yeah, it says don't fuck with me at least 3 times. If you can't, don't get it by the 3rd time, then you're just deaf.
I mean, then, you know, yeah, you're going to get fucked up. So.
Yeah.
What do you think Axel is trying to say with this verse? What message is he trying to put out to the universe?
I don't even know what this whole song is.
Let's have a little therapy session here. Let me see. Nobody's put the lyrics in the comments section, unfortunately. So, let's see. Axel, Mr. Rose, consider us your therapists. I mean, you don't have to pay us if you know, want to, whatever, but, you know, we appreciate it, but, you know, you don't have to, but, you know, we're just trying to, to help you here, and, it seems like you got something to say. So now, when you say, to keep the demons down and drag the skeletons out, because a blind man is following you in chains. Am I meant to take this literally? And if not, what kind of metaphor is this supposed to be?
That I don't know. That's something he'd have to answer. I only answer to God.
Well, Chris, what do you think he's trying to say when he says, don't fuck with the bad side of... sorry. Don't fuck with the bad side of me.
I guess... I don't know, maybe it's probably like people piss him off, whatever. And he says, don't fuck with me. You know, you don't want to, you know.
Well, let's look at a few things that have pissed Axl Rose. I almost said Axl Ross. Let's look at a few things that have pissed off Axl Rose over the years, and let's see. Rocks. Bottle rockets.
Bottles.
Bottles.
I think most people in general have pissed him off.
Being photographed at the airport. So far, I'm not seeing anything unreasonable.
Most reporters, music journalists.
A middle-aged man with a disposable camera.
Yeah. a famed guitarist in a top hat once pissed him off.
We still don't know why. I'm telling you, that was a work. They were working all of us. There's got to be a list. I wonder if I can Google things that have pissed off Axl Rose.
The entire media, every, I don't know, Rolling Stones. Bob Guccione Jr. just play Get in the Ring. There's everyone who's pissed him off. He threatens the fight.
Oh, if I found an article called 18 Reasons Why Axl Rose is the Biggest Douchebag in Rock and Roll.
Funny.
Yeah, somebody want to put together that list? I can't believe nobody's put together that list. Top 10 things that pissed off Axl Rose. You know who's going to be on that list? let's see. There's the time he sent a roadie overseas to fetch a jacket.
Oh, I remember that story.
Let's see. What else we got? Oh, wait. He held up he was late to a concert because of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. He wanted to watch Ninja Turtle.
Ninja Turtles 3, man. Apparently that was, I don't know. That just had a hold on you.
Look, dude. Fucking, don't hate. Okay, a man's got his priorities. Okay?
That's true, but, I mean, God, give me something better than that. Like, listen, if he's trying to, like, you know, finish fucking beating, like, Grand Theft Auto Vice City or something, I'd be like, okay, cool. Like, I get you. Some of those, you know, there's some really hard shit in that game, but give me something. Not watching shit.
And then there's
fucking
the story.
TMNT movies.
Then there's the story of where he killed a moth with a shotgun.
Yes, that's a fucking good one.
Hey, man, I still stand by no kill like overkill.
True.
All right, let's get back.
Let's get back to the song, man. I can forget.
Yeah, I forgot we were doing this.
We'll throw some more facts about the song and stuff afterwards.
Okay.
Bum, bum, bum. We just forget the countdown.
Bum, 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 bum.
It's cool to get like a breakdown in the middle of this like very punk rock song that's like blistering fast.
Yeah, I don't
and then
hate
it. Goes
it.
Right back into it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And the fucking solos, I guess.
Yeah, I love that part. Let him be, dude.
Just let him be. Fuck.
Don't fuck with him. Like when he killed a moth with a shotgun, and that was a perfect round.
Yep.
It's a perfect shot. Had to be.
Well, I think he missed the first few times, but. Like he was going wild. Like, ah.
Oh, man. Well, there you go. Perfect crime. We've listened to it. You got some facts, though. Let's hear some facts before we get
to our... Yeah, I mean, just more like stuff from like Setlist FM here. So the first time it was played was Halloween in 1986. Hmm. And that's, I think, when they opened for Red Hot Chili Peppers or something, I believe.
So 5 years before it was released.
Pretty much, yeah. And it was played a couple times here and there. It was played a lot in like 91 and 92. Actually, ironically, the last time this was ever played was at the in Montreal, the Olympic Stadium riot.
Huh. Did not know that.
Fuck this, we're retiring it. this caused a riot. Nope.
Did this cause a riot?
I don't know, but they played at that show where the Montreal riots happened.
Well, you see, you guys shouldn't have rioted.
Yeah.
It's like, don't fuck with me. I'll take away songs. I just won't sing songs I don't like to sing.
Yeah. And if you ever listen to like live performance of this, like this like wins the fuck out of Axl because he's like running around like a maniac and he's like trying to deliver these lyrics at the same speed here. Oh, so it's really tough, especially because I think that's why somehow it got played literally 44 times.
Huh.
And it was a lot of the times it was like an opener too, I believe, on the Illusions Tour shows.
I'd like to see him open with this these days.
Yeah, okay, the show would be done after 3 minutes.
Oh, man, that'd be embarrassing. Well, what did you think? You want to do some ratings? You want to go first?
Yeah, I'll go first on this one. It's short but sweet. It's what it needs to be. This is like the most punk rock of like all of the Guns N' Roses discography, I'd say. Where it's just quick, it's to the point, it's just go, go, go. We got that little breakdown too. And then right into the solo, which is fucking amazing. Solo from Slash. This one is hard not to skip, so I'm probably going to go 5 out of 5 on this one. I really like this.
Oh, nice.
I think it's kick-ass. It's quick. You want some quick rock and roll? Here you go. Perfect crime.
I try not to hold the fact that I can't understand the lyrics out of... not hold it against it. But... it does kind of affect my being able to sing along with it. It's not one that I listen to regularly. It is fast and it is quick, but I do listen to it sometimes when I'm jamming to some GNR. I can't give it 5 out of 5 because it's not one. I don't put it. There's a certain category I have that when it comes to GNR songs, there's a tier. All right. You got your main eventers, you got your upper mid-carders, your mid-carders, your jobbers, like My World. It's like wrestling. But this one is I would say, this is an intercontinental champion of songs.
Okay. I can see why.
And, I'd give it 4.5.
All right.
But what did you think? Because if you're listening on Spotify, down here in that description... doobly doo in the digits, in the thing in my day jig, and in the thingy on your phone, we got a poll up where you can vote and leave your rating for Perfect Crime. So you agree with us? You don't agree with us? However you want to vote, let us know. And also, when you vote, it shows everybody else's, so you can see if other people agree with us too. So that's another interesting dynamic to have. And of course, as always, you can contact us using the links in the description to let us know, I don't know, what you thought of the song, what you thought about the show, if you ever got busted for something stupid and you want to be added to the stupid criminals list.
Sure.
Yeah.
What, are we snitching our own fans then?
No, they're welcome to snitch themselves, but we'll make fun of them. If you've done something stupid and you want us to roast you, please let us know by contacting us on Discord. By the way, you should be in our fucking Discord, man, because I'm going to talk about... I should have talked about this at the beginning of the show. I'd intended on it. But have you been seeing these videos Franz has been dropping?
Yeah, dude, a lot of creative guys have been dropping stuff in there.
Recently. Our photo dump page on the Discord has blown up.
Franz zone over there.
Yeah, this is Franz world over here. Franz released a 4K Ultra HD version of Civil War. And I downloaded it because I was like, I'm going to check it out. And honestly, I did not expect to be as impressed as I was by the quality of that video. If you saw it, did you see it?
I haven't gotten to it yet. I'm pretty sure I got the link for it, but I haven't.
Well, dude, it's fucking incredible. The quality is... It's amazing. And if you... I think the link may have already expired. I'll have to send it to you, maybe separate.
No, but, I have it downloaded. I just haven't watched it.
Well, the quality of it is fucking incredible. And if you guys missed it, like I said, I think the link's expired or whatever, but if you missed it, man, that sucked to miss, because that was awesome. And he's got some more things coming out soon. He's always dropping stuff like that in our Discord. And, you know, hey, I want to say I appreciate it.
Oh, hell yeah, we always do. I mean, I think we shout him out almost every week on this show, so.
We kind of do. We definitely have our... people and friends that we interact with the most in this community. Mm-hmm. There's Franz, and then there's Jeff, who drunk texted me last night.
I think he drunk texted both of us. He's like, I'm 5 beers deep. I'm like, all right, nice. You do you, man.
Dude, I was fucked up too last night. I mean, that's why I'm over here yodding. Everything else, man, I'm hungover too. But yeah, man, there's a lot of fun shit that goes on in our Discord. So if you're not a member, it's free to join. I don't know what the fuck you're doing. Get the invite link in the bottom and come with us. And all kinds of great things happen in there. It ain't always... Party. It's not one of those Discords that's just constantly rolling. Like if you check out, you're going to miss so much of the conversation that you got to, you know, check back in. Mm-hmm. You got to read a little while, figure out what everybody's fucking talking about. It's not one of those. It doesn't just constantly roll. But man, when it hits, it hits. It hits hard when it hits, and it hits well. Oh, yeah. So, yeah. I think probably of everything that we've done with this podcast, one of my favorite decisions we've made is having set up the Discord. So.
Hell yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, I was going to say, let's spin that wheel. Let's see what we're going to get next week. More fun shit coming along. Not just our Discord, even this podcast is great fun.
I know, right? Get that wheel spent. I think it's going to try to punish us for not listening to the Duff song with another Duff song. I called it.
Ah, balls.
We're going to be listening to Sick by Loaded. Unless, do you want to do what we did last week and push it off to a Shotcast?
No, I don't know if we can do it 2 weeks in a row. And then that kind of like, then we're kind of just ruining our gimmick there.
All right, fine. Okay.
Plus, I think you can make some good shit with art for next week, so.
Oh, man. Yeah, I've got an idea already, so. Well, other than that, I mean, be sure to come back on Saturday for an all-new edition of Shotcast Saturday. And last-minute announcement here, since this is going to air on Monday, come back to the channel on Wednesday. Because guess what's coming back on Wednesday? Not full-time, just a special episode. Ooh. But an all-new episode of Band... The Real Life Misadventures of Rick Dunsford and Friends is going to be up on Wednesday.
Woo! As it stands. For now.
As it stands right now, we're planning on recording it. So, we're going to be talking about... I don't know what we're going to talk about. If Rick wants to go ahead and wrap up with the finale show, or if he wants to do something else. I don't know. We haven't recorded it yet, full disclosure. But when Rick tells me what we're doing, that's what we'll do, so... be sure to check that out and come back on Saturday. And until next time, I'm Dustin Bowes.
And I'm Chris Caputo. We'll see you here Saturday for another edition of Shotcast Saturday and next Monday for another banging ass episode of Guns and Radio. But until then, peace.